Hello and welcome to my shop. Today's short video is on the modification of the Z-axis of my tool grinder. Originally, the spindle of the Z-axis is supported by a thrust bearing which takes the weight of the vertical slide. Any upward forces are taken by a primitive ring. Both the ring and the bevel gear are just pinned onto the spindle. There is a lot of axial play in the spindle and no means of adjustment. I intended to add a second axial bearing to improve the situation and bring the axial play down to hopefully zero. The diameter of the original reset in the housing is slightly too small to accept the axial bearing. My plan was to use my favorite tool, the Wohlhaupter boring and facing head, to enlarge the bore. As the work is too tall to fit between the table and the spindle of my milling machine, I had to use the motor mount of the tool grinder as a primitive angle plate hanging over the table. The angle of the table was adjusted so that the axis of the quill was aligned to the pretty rough surface of the plate. The work was clamped onto the plate. The original bore was roughly centered to the spindle of the mill by eyeballing. A central cutter helped to bring the alignment sufficiently close to zero. This isn't super critical as we are just creating a clearance hole. I set a stop to the depth of the original hole. I set up the boring head so that the tool just scratched the diameter of the bore. This was the first cut. Actually, I did a scratch pass before. I didn't want to bore you with that. Thank you. I had some issues with chatter and the surface finish wasn't great. Thus I reground the high-speed cutter and tried again. This time I was happy with the result. Off camera I made a washer with a recess and inserted and glued an M8 thread into the spindle. Test fit was really satisfactory, no play at all and the spindle ran smoothly. That's it for today, thanks for watching.